Today's message is brought to you by the Partners and Friends and Anthony Trice Ministries.
God ordered if you get healed, then you get the other stuff. The Bible says, come from among them and be ye separate and touch not the unclean thing.
Do you have faith in the Word of God?
Let's get into the Word with Dr. Anthony L. Trice.
How many of you have heard it say that there is no such thing as a fair fight? Is that right? Murphy's Law says that there is no such thing as a fair fight, only the one you win or the one you lose. Amen?
Amen.
Because the enemy will attack you on two occasions. Is that right?
Amen.
First of all, when you are ready and when you are not. Rest assured. Now, as we begin to look into the scripture, amen, we see that the children of Israel, they have crossed over the Jordan and they have entered into the promised land. They're in a place that is flowing with milk and honey, amen. They have land and they have houses that they had not to build. They have vineyards and they are prosperous, amen. And as we look on, we see that Solomon has built the temple and now they have a place to worship their God. Things look pretty good, don't they?
Amen.
And as we look at Jehoshaphat, he is their king, and God has used him to bring things in order. How many know every now and then, in the people of God or the house of God, things can get what? Out of order, is that right?
Amen.
So he used him. This is Solomon's great-grandson. God used Jehoshaphat to bring order to God's people, amen. And the Bible says that Jehoshaphat did that which was right in the sight of God. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. But I only came to tell you today that even when you do what's right in the sight of God, you're going to have some trouble.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Job said, man that is born of a woman is of a few days and full of trouble.
Yeah.
But one thing I'm glad about is that trouble don't last always.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want you to know that you're built to last. You're built to outlast trouble. You're built to endure. You're built to overcome. You're built to walk in victory. There's something on the inside. Working on the outside. You know it's the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. You are a designer original. You're specifically designed by God. And there are times, hallelujah, that you will find yourself in a little bit of trouble. But I'm so glad that God is a deliverer. Amen. He's able to deliver us out of distress. He's able to heal our bodies. He's able to touch our minds. Whatever it is, God is able. And it is written in the Word that when the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the living God will lift up a standard against him. How many in here today is having just a little bit of trouble? How many feel like your back is against the wall? How many people are in here today that say, I don't know how I'm going to handle this? I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't know how I'm going to deal with it. Their location was at Hezron, Texas. Tamar. They were only 15 miles away. Then you get news that three different armies is coming up against you. Amen. Hallelujah. But the Bible says in verses 3 and 4 that Jehoshaphat feared. And I want you to know that fear is a natural reaction. And God knew that there are times that we will be in situations that will make us afraid. That's why he wrote in Isaiah chapter 40, fear thou not, because I am with you. I will help you. I will strengthen you. I will uphold you with the right hand of my righteousness. Hallelujah. So God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of love and power and of a sound mind. But because Jehoshaphat was fearful, he set himself to seek the Lord. Amen. I want to ask a question in here. How many of you, when you get a situation that's overpowering you, do you set yourself to seek God? Hallelujah. So many times we're guilty. We'll get on the phone. You know, the cell phones. We'll tweet. Amen. And we'll text. Is that right? And we get on Facebook. And we give people too much information. Amen. Hallelujah. All the things that know their God. Somebody say, I want to talk to God. I want to know what God is saying about my situation. To God. I can tell you, all I need is one word from God. All I need is one word, no matter what I'm facing, because I know that when God speaks, it is so. The Bible says that he's not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he would have to repent. So when God speaks, it is so. You might not have two nipples to rub together, but when God says, was built so here. You've been around this mountain long enough. And God told me it was time to move out. And if you look in the second chapter of Deuteronomy, he said, Esau and the rest of them are looking at you. He said, but I want you to hold your head up and step on into the promised land. Go on where I told you to go. He said, yeah, they're scared of you now. You know why? You know why? Because not that you so bad, but they scared of you because of who I am. And he said, I don't want you to meddle them. I don't want you to bother them. I want you to just keep stepping. Walk over into the promised land. Hallelujah. How many know? And now Jehoshaphat say, now look, Lord, you told us don't bother them. Has God told you don't bother nobody? Has he told you to be quiet? Did you do it? Amen. So now Jehoshaphat is reminding them, you said God don't bother them. See, because we were strong men, and we were great in number, and we were filling our oats, and we could have took them. Do you know somebody tried to do you and you know you could have got them? That's what he's saying. He said, no, God, you said vengeance is yours and you will repay. So we kept on walking. See, I want to put something in here for those of you that are trying to play tit for tat with somebody. Those of you that are trying to get even with somebody. Those of you that are trying to put, you're trying to make a point with somebody. You better drop it. Unless the Lord told you to do it, you better step back and take your hands off of. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, that God know what he's doing. Hallelujah. God is not confused. He said, yeah, you will enter in. And many times, what the enemy will do, you're just about to be blessed. You're just about to enter in. That's what the Lord has for you. And the enemy will distract you. God, you will fall out with somebody. Come on, talk to me. Oh, yeah, I know. We fall out in church. And I ain't coming back no more. We kept the job. We walked off the job. Because they didn't do me right. And many times God is saying, I just want you to sit tight. I just want you to hold on. I'm going to step in the situation. I'm going to fix it. Things that you think you can't overcome. Things you think that you can't get over. God said, if you just get in my presence, I'll give you the victory. I'll help you to forgive. I'll help you to look over. I'll help you to see it in a different manner. I'll break up the spirit of offense off of you. Oh, glory be unto God. I'm going to make it get the root of goodness.
Crazy.
best he could do for us.
Yeah.
You know, and I wanted to, and I was talking to God. I said, God, this baby finna come. And I don't have nothing for the baby. I don't have a crib. I don't have no diapers. I don't have nothing. And I said, yeah, time's been so hard. I don't even have a decent, as we said back then, house coat. To be in the hospital. I said, and on top of that, they're trying to send me to the Cook County Hospital where I had my first baby, and it was a bad situation because we didn't have no insurance. You know, life is funny because I was in a clinic. I won't take a lot of time, but I was in the Board of Health clinic, and all these young girls was walking up there. And they had back then what they call a green card. And they was naming off all the hospitals they wanted to go to. And then I'm a taxpayer, and you gonna tell me, you ain't got no place for me. Something wrong with it. To make a long story short, the baby was born Tuesday. Monday was Memorial Day. Saturday, the mailman gave me a green card. That Friday, my friend wanted me to come over the house for lunch. I really didn't feel like it. I was out there, you know, I'm dragging. I didn't want to go. But I kept getting a prompt to go. And when I went, they gave me a surprise baby shower. Walked up to me and she gave it to me. She said, the Lord told me to get you this. I opened the box. What's in the box? Brand new one. The Lord blessed us so that that little girl never wore the same outfit twice for a whole year. God did that. Amen. Now let's get back. Hallelujah. We were right where Jehoshaphat acknowledged that he didn't know what to do.
Amen.
See, because when that friend of mine asked me what was I going to do, I had no answers. What do you mean, what I'm going to do? I ain't got nothing to do nothing with. But I'm going to call on the name of the Lord. And one thing about it is, we get down to verse 13. It says that God sends an answer to their prayer. This is what I like. As they continue to stand before the Lord, the Spirit of the living God spoke through the prophet Jahaziel. And God told them that this battle was not theirs, but it was his. Amen. Hallelujah. What I like about it is the fact that God answered prayer before the prayer meeting was over. How many of you done had a prayer meeting? Some of you done told God about it. God done answered the prayer already. You're just waiting on the manifestation. Part that I love. It said that the Levites stood up to praise their God. And then the Bible goes on to say, with their voices loud and high. Hallelujah. And I began to look at that. I said, Lord, you know what? We come in your house, not here, but I've seen it. And we don't even want to stand up. We come to your house. We don't even want to lift our hands. You walk in here, everybody can look at you and know you're going through. But baby, I'm here to tell you, when you want to get the double or run for his money, you gotta learn how to praise the Lord.
Christ.
and be ready to go in the battle. See, that's what we fall off at. See, because we love to jump and shout. Is that right? But I want you to know when you get through jumping and shouting, you still got to put on the whole line of God.
Thank you for watching today's broadcast. If ever in the St. Louis area, please come visit our North Campus, located 7200 West Florissant, St. Louis, Missouri, 63136, or give us a call. We would love to hear from you at 314-659-8522. For more information on how to get connected, write to us or visit us online at anthonytrice.org. And we thank you for your continued support.